Tell me about a boyfriend. Who stands out in your mind?
When I was in TLC, the first producer that we worked with was Dallas Austin. I was in the relationship. I got pregnant, first time, and I didn't have the support. And so I was so scared, and I didn't know what to do, and chose to not have it. One of the biggest mistakes.
Why was it the biggest mistake?
Because I didn't want to do that.
Did you feel forced?
I'm 20. My career hadn't even really started, you know. So how do I do all that?
Yeah.
How can I be a mommy? It messed me up. I don't know. It just, it broke my spirit. That's what it did. Mm-hmm.
It changed you from what to what?
I feel like I became, like, I don't know, kind of like, not my strong self anymore. Mm-hmm. I felt like I gave in and I broke to what someone else wanted. Mm-hmm. And I would break down and I would just cry. Because because I wasn't a mommy.
Doctor who performs abortions is back in the spotlight this midday. His clinic shut down a while ago, but now he's reopened a surgery center.
He is now the only doctor in the area who will perform late-term abortions. That's for women who are up to 6 months pregnant. It's no surprise that he's been the target of protests, but as KVU's Jim Douglas shows us, there is a surprise in the doctor's story.
Am I killing? Yes, I am. I know that.
It's a jarring admission from anyone, especially from a doctor, and perhaps even more so from this doctor.
I'm an ordained Baptist minister.
Yeah, hi. This is Voice. I'm at Southwestern Women's Options. I have a patient we need to transfer to the hospital.
What's the address, ma'am?
522 Lomas.
Okay, and the phone number you're calling from?
242-7512.
Okay. What's the problem tonight? Can you tell me?
She just had a second try procedure, and she's has a fever that's spiking right now, and then her pulse is up to 172 with some bleeding that they can't get under control.
Are you with her right now?
I am not. The doctor is, and a nurse practitioner.
Where is the bleeding coming from?
It's her uterine. It's uterine bleeding.
Oh, uterine. Okay.
Uterine.
Oh, uterine. Okay.
Yeah.
How old is she, ma'am?
Approximately. Let me look at the chart. She is 17.
man is in jail after police say he drove to Central Florida to have sex with a teenage girl and her parents.
You have not really been walking tightly, closely with Jesus. And until you have that communion, until you have that, you don't know the power that's available to you.
I had known ever since I can remember that I had been not only adopted, but I had been born about 4 months premature. And I knew that I had been very sick and very tiny, and that the doctors didn't have a very good prognosis for my life. And to me, I didn't have a lot of questions about that growing up, because I guess to me it didn't matter, because I was healthy, I was in a great home, I was loved, and life was good.
But Melissa only knew part of the story. She was 14 when her older sister got pregnant out of wedlock and considered an abortion. Melissa's mother, Linda, wanted to stop her daughter from having the abortion and told her daughters the shocking circumstances of Melissa's birth.
She said, you know, we never meant to keep it from you. There's no easy way to tell you this. Please know that we'll always love you. And then she just kind of blurted it out. She said, you know, Melissa, your mother had an abortion during her fifth month of pregnancy with you, and you survived it.
In 1978, Melissa's teenage birth mother walked into an abortion clinic expecting to walk out with her problem solved. She chose a saline injection to end the life of her five-month-old baby. When the procedure was over, a nurse heard her two-pound baby crying from the discarded medical waste. Social services knew Mr. and Mrs. Cross wanted to adopt another baby girl, but they didn't know if they would take such a high-risk baby.
When we first saw Melissa, her head was shaved from temple to temple because she was too little to suck, and they fed her intravenously. Told us all the things that could be wrong with her because of the premature birth, but as soon as they put her in my arms, I knew she was going to be fine. She was just beautiful, absolutely beautiful.
Melissa recovered completely and lived a normal childhood.
If I die young, bury me in satin, lay me down on a bed of roses, sink me in the river. At dawn, send me away with the world of love song. Lord, make me a rainbow, shine down on my mind.
What I never did is done.